start the chapter 1. We are going to start the chapter 1. The name of the chapter is Plant Reproduction. What is reproduction? All living beings reproduce and give rise to the young ones, like their own kind. This process is called the reproduction. Reproduction, we know that all living beings directly or indirectly depend upon the plants. Then you must be thinking, plants reproduce. They reproduce by three methods: vegetative propagation, reproduction by spores, reproduction by seeds. What is vegetative propagation? When the new plant arises from the different parts of the plant, this process is called the vegetative propagation. It is further when the new plants grow from the root. First of all, we discuss vegetative propagation by growing plants by root. In some plant species, new plant arise from the roots, such as sweet potato, apple, pear, etc. In the sweet potato plant, you see that there is a baby plant. So baby plant come out from the root of the from this root. When the cutting of the this root is sown into the soil, it gives rise to the new sweet potato plant. In the same way, next is growing plant by stem. It is by underground stem. From underground stem and stem cutting. You have ever seen few vegetables in your kitchen like potato, ginger, onion. All these are underground stems. These stems have buds, which are called as eye. From these eyes, the new plant grows. When the piece of the potato in with bud is sown into the soil, it gives rise to the new plant. Similarly, when onion is planted in the soil, it gives rise to the new onion plant. Now stem cutting, right? Stem cutting. Some plants like sugarcane, hibiscus, rose, hibiscus, the new plants arise from the stem of the plant. We cut the stem of the sugarcane and plant it into the soil. It develops roots and gives rise to the new sugarcane plant. Now, growing plants by leaves. Leafy plant. one grow into the new bryophyllum plant. Each one grow into the new bryophyllum plant. These are the buds of the bryophyllum. Now, this is seed coat. We find one or when we open this, we find one or two fleshy seed leaves, which is called as cotyledon. This is called as cotyledon. And this is radicle. And this is plumule. Germination. get favorable conditions, the seed pod become the seed pseudolon and the seed pod burst. A small baby plant come out from it. It has root and small greeny. This is a greeny shoot. After that, as the plant, this seedling, this is the seedling stage. As the seedling grow, it has mature root and shoot. After that, it has properly developed green leaves and root. In this stage, the plant takes food like mineral and water. Its roots are absorbed from the soil. In this stage, the cotyledon is disappeared because cotyledon provides food in the early stage of the seed to the embryo. Now it has disappeared now. Now all seeds are not necessary to produce into the new plant. Why? Because sometimes all these conditions like water, air, space, sunlight, warmth is not everything. So some of the seeds lead to die or growth of the unhealthy. Some of seeds are eaten by birds and vegetables and animals. Some seeds, this is insufficient. Some seeds are died due to harsh weather condition. So all seeds are not necessary to produce into the new plant. Now we cover this topic now. After that, we do the dispersal of seed. Dispersal of seed. What is the meaning of dispersal? Dispersal means to scatter. The seedling grow in cluster, they get insufficient air, water and sunlight. So some of the seeds die and or growth of the unhealthy plant. So dispersal of seed is necessary. Dispersal of seed, when the mature seeds are scattered, dispersed to the other places from their parent plant by some agents, for the dispersal of seed. These agents are wind. These agents are dispersal of seed. In this, the agents are wind, water, animals, birds, and explosion of seed. What is the definition of the dispersal of the seed? The scattering of the seeds away from their parent plant is called dispersal of seed. It's called dispersal of seeds. This is definition of the dispersal of the seeds. It is done by the wind, water, and and explosion of seeds. First, dispersal of seeds by wind.
We do the topic agriculture.
the growing crops on large scale for food and other purposes is called crop. This is called crop. The practice of growing crops is called agriculture. Now, different crops need different type of the climatic condition, soil condition and temperature. So different type of the crops are grown in different seasons. Some crops are grown in summer season while other crops are grown in winter season. The crops is called kharif crops. These are called the kharif crops. These are grown in the month of June and harvested in the month of October. The example of these crops are rice, barley, etc. The crops which are grown in winter season are called rabi crops. These are grown in the month of November and harvested in the month of April. In the last month, you see that we harvested the wheat crop. For example, wheat, oats, etc. Now, after that, we will do the increasing productivity. The topic. Increase the productivity of the soil. Farmers add manure and fertilizer to their field. Why they add manure and fertilizer? Because when they grow crops year after year, the fertility of the soil decreases. So they to increase the fertility of the soil, they add manure and fertilizer. What is fertilizer? Fertilizers are the chemicals. These are the chemicals. They increase the quality of the soil and increase the fertility of the soil. For example, ammonium sulfate nitrate but it causes no harm to the animals. Those are living. by plow the field. Make the soil loose. Next is, they water the plant. The plant well by giving right amount of water. After that, they protect the crop from various disease pest fungi and insects by spraying insecticide, fungicide and pesticide. Now they protect the crop. In the last, they store harvested crop and protect it from the various from the insects, animals and moisture. Dispersal of seed, agriculture and increase the productivity. In the last, I want to give you one activity regarding this lesson. You will take some black plants and soak them in water overnight. In the morning, you find out that there are some white portion comes out from it. See that? White portion come out from it. And sow it into the soil. You find out that after 2 and 3 days after, the new baby plant seedling arise from these seeds. I hope you try this activity at home also and you enjoy this lesson a lot. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay safe. Stay healthy.